Good morning, everyone out there following us. Thank you for the interest. We'll try to give you an update on how these guys are doing. There's a new development. You've probably been following it over, watching Angel on the camera. What has happened with her is a couple of weeks ago, it started to get contracted in the front limbs, and by that I mean the back tendons or the flexor tendons, the ones that make the limb flex, got shorter, so the limb got to be kind of a bowing forward or bending that knee, so they get to be like toe walking. And basically the way she looked, and I'm gonna try the best I can to show you this. So that first one right here, where my hand is kind of exemplifying a contracted tendon. So you can see the tip of that hoof. It's on the ground. So unfortunately, that makes it a very difficult way for them to move and ambulate and get around. So what we do for that, we make a splint, then we put those PVC splint pipes on the back of the leg. When you don't use those tendons, they get relaxed, the muscles and the tendons relax, getting to be in a normal position. The unfortunate consequence to that sometimes is that they get too lax. So now you can see what happened to Angel, where my finger is on this image on top, is that the fetlock is almost on the ground. This line exemplifies the ground. The foot is flipping up. Now the toe is on the air, so basically leaping up, and the whole leg was bowing extremely. So what do you do to correct that is to prevent this foot from flipping up in the air is gluing right here a wood splint or any kind of a plastic material with acrylic, so it'll be like having snow skis and avoiding that toe from flipping up in the air. So immediately when you do this, that we did that yesterday, that ankle got off the ground like this picture shows. Hopefully you guys can see this. And she's walking way, way better. The knee is better aligned. And, you know, it's not so far back at the knee as she was. And hopefully that bandage that we have on her now is a lot lighter. So she can bend that knee some, start using her muscles, her tendons, gain strength, and hopefully after a week or so, we can take that special shoe that we glue on her feet off, and she can be back on her normal track. So you're going to see, if you guys observe the way she's walking, I think she's a little happier the way her limbs are moving. Everything else, if anything, I feel that perhaps they're growing too fast. Perhaps they're growing too fast, and you have to accommodate and be very, very careful watching every day and noticing those little changes to act quickly enough so we can get ahead of the game and be able to help them. Babies at this age respond so fast to therapy, but at the same time, if you don't react fast enough, you get behind the eight ball, and it's really hard to get them back on track. So that's why, if you see this plane with the splints, the bandages, the special shoes, is trying to get them to keep growing the same rate they are without any complications. So, but everything else, as you guys see, Sunny is doing really, really well. And I think it's a little bit of a troublemaker and busybody. And that's kind of what you want to see in a healthy colt his age. Our little girl here, Angel, I think she's definitely gaining quite a bit of weight and is catching up fast. Unfortunately, we need to keep dealing with this problem with her limbs. But I do believe that the way she's responding so favorably will be in good shape. Thank you for keep visiting with us, and good company and good comments, and wishing well for all of us. And hopefully we'll have a very happy outcome. See you guys later.
Just wait for some questions.
Okay. My mother, she used to go home.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, right, particularly looks so much better.
Will Sunny and Angel get out to run more?
Unfortunately, Sunny is getting to have a little bit more opportunity to have more time out, and sometimes you guys don't get to see it, but he goes out with Mom. Angel is really delicate to have a lot of a free roaming time because they can hurt themselves by just doing too much. So until she gets back on those front limbs to be straight and level and strong enough, as soon as that happens, she's gonna start getting some more tune-out time.
The weights?
The weights, actually, they're doing really well. Angel is weighing about 65 pounds, so she's like double her weight since birth, at least. And Sunny, we're guessing about 85 pounds or so. So it's they're gaining weight. You can see how her gluteal muscles, her butts are developing. If anything, I think they might be growing a little bit too fast now for their own good, because I think the restriction in utero, and now they're getting a really good supply of food. Mom is doing great keeping up with the demands of these guys, so we're pretty happy. I think I just answered that question. Yes, she's producing a phenomenally good amount of milk, and I think we're noticing that because the babies are getting very well hydrated. They're urinating as many times as they need to urinate for a normal baby. They alternate. They don't seem to be fighting over. They take their time. I think they have adapted to their timings. It seems like Lena actually calls them up when she's ready with a full bag, and then they come empty it up and they go and rest. So I think that she is keeping up pretty well. Swimming therapy is not a good thing for babies. It's just, it's really interesting concept, but you need to use muscles and tendons. Their weight needs to be on their limbs to be of benefit. So floating type of exercise for what they have is not a good thing. So it's for other kind of injuries in adult horses. Will somebody ask if long term will be any kind of a long term negative effect on Angel's limbs? Hopefully not. By that we know is we radiograph this front limbs, particularly the knee, the carpal bones, equivalent to what we call our knees, but it's really not. You know, it's a front limb. But they have these sugar cube shaped bones where if they get to be crushed or mouth shapen, that will carry a long life problems. But that's why we keep splinting them and trying to keep them aligned so they don't get permanent damage. So hopefully, we're hoping that Angel won't have permanent damage. The reason why Sunny got splinted also is because I believe due to his fast growth, he was starting to contract and get buckled over at the knees. So he was starting to fall forward. And the way we counteract that was the same thing we did with Angel, is putting splints. He laxed up enough in a couple of days, and that was enough. So we're going to keep monitoring his growth and contraction of those limbs, and that needs to be done again. We may do it for a short period of time.